Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss trigonometry of right triangles. Let's start with an example. So we have a right triangle here with sides 3, 4, and 5, and the directions are to find all trigonometric function values of theta. Let's work through this solution. So there's something very useful we can use to solve this problem. It's the following. It's SOH CAH TOA, very, very powerful, and it will let us get the answer. This tells us the sine of theta is opposite over hypotenuse, cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse, and tangent is opposite over adjacent. So I'm going to go ahead and label everything in the triangle so you see it. The 5 is going to be our hypotenuse, and the 4 is our adjacent, and the 3 is our opposite. It's opposite the angle. Okay, so let's go ahead and write the answers down. So the sine of theta is opposite over hypotenuse, so it'll be 3 over 5. That's one answer. And then for the cosecant of theta, which is the reciprocal, you can just flip your answer because it's the reciprocal, so that's 5 over 3. That's another answer. Let's do cosine now. Cosine of theta is adjacent over hypotenuse, so it'll be 4 over 5. Right, 4 over 5, adjacent over hypotenuse, and then the reciprocal is secant, so you just basically flip the fraction, so 5 over 4. So two more answers here. Very powerful, SOH CAH TOA, lets you do a lot of trig problems. And then we have the tangent of theta, which is opposite over adjacent, so that'll be 3 over 4. That's another answer there. And last, and certainly not least, the cotangent of theta is the reciprocal of tangent. So you just flip it, so you get 4 over 3. 4 over 3. And those are all the trig function values of theta. So recap, if you use SOH CAH TOA when you have a triangle, you can find all the trig function values of that triangle, assuming you have all of the sides. All right, let's do something a little bit different. In this example, we are going to do a word problem. The question says, a building cast a shadow 100 feet long. Find the height of the building if the angle of elevation of the sun is 20 degrees. Let's work through it carefully. Solution. Draw a little picture to describe what's happening here. We have a building, which I'll draw here in blue. Here's our fancy building. And we have the sun, so I'm going to draw the sun up here in yellow. So here's the sun, the happy sun. And it's casting a shadow, or rather the building is casting a shadow because of the sun that's behind it. So, and then here is the ground. Okay. And then here's our angle. This is the angle of elevation at 20. The angle of elevation of the sun. And we have to find the height of the building. So I'm going to call that H. And we know that the shadow is 100 feet long, so that's going to be here. So based off this picture, we have to find H. So we have to think about SOH CAH TOA, because that's helpful. And we have to think about what we have. We have the opposite and we have the adjacent. So that means that we're going to use tangent. So the tangent of 20 degrees is equal to opposite over adjacent, so H over 100. And again, we need to use tangent because that's what's given in the problem, the opposite and the adjacent. We can solve this for H by multiplying both sides by 100. These cancel. I'm gonna write the H over here on the left. So we have 100 times the tangent of 20 degrees. And it's super important to make sure you're in degree mode when you're using your calculator. If you put this in your calculator and you round to the nearest whole number, this is approximately 36, and then the units are feet. And so that would be the height of the building. So the building is approximately 36 feet, and it's casting a shadow that is 100 feet long when the angle of elevation of the sun is 20 degrees. Kind of an interesting problem. If you've enjoyed this video and you've learned some math, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck and take care.